I am a voice crying out in the wilderness.
Good news for him and for you and for everybody, because we are going to have peace in Jerusalem.
The Key of David with Gerald Flurry.
Greetings, everyone. If you study Bible history, you will find that when God sent his message, it always ended up being rejected. You can read in the Bible many times where he sent prophets and the people rejected that message and often killed the prophets. Now, we know that the whole world is deceived, and they're deceived about, well, where is God's church and how can you know where it is? How can you prove where it is beyond a shadow of a doubt? Matthew 16, verse 18 says that God would build his church and the gates of hell would not prevail against it, or it would never die. So if you're going to find that church, what do you look for? If you're going to find where Christ is working on this church, what do you look for? What is it that you should be looking for? Now, the church has a little strength, and it's a little flock. And yet, how do you identify it? And what the Bible says may shock you somewhat, because it isn't primarily doctrine that you're looking for. It's certainly not large numbers, because it's a little flock with little strength. But what do you look for to identify God's true church? And if you look at Revelation 3, you will see that it's an open door that really primarily identifies God's church, where it is, what it's doing. And it is delivering a message, a Key of David message, through that open door. Let's notice Revelation 3 and verse 7. We need to understand what this open door is if it identifies God's church. Notice verse 7. And to the angel of the church in Philadelphia write, these things says he that is holy, and he that is true, and he that has the Key of David, he that opens and no man shuts, and shuts and no man opens. Now, Christ himself opens this door, and he has here in this very end time the Key of David, which of course is the greatest vision in all the Bible. But he opens a door and really challenges the skeptics and the critics and everybody else and says he opens that door and no man, not a billion men or a billion demons, can shut it. Now, that's quite a challenge. If the scholars and the educators would really like to prove that God's church really is alive as Christ said it would be and would continue from the time he built it to the very end, I mean, here is a real challenge for anybody who is interested in knowing, how do you identify God's true church? Surely, we all want to know that, but the exciting thing about it here is, I believe, is that Christ himself opens that door. He's the head of the church. He opens the door, and through that door goes this Key of David message. And so, if you understand what this door, this open door, is all about, you can always identify where God's church is. You can always do that. So, how many people do you think understand this? I don't think there are very many. I'm telling you, and we need to look at this closely. I do, you do, we all do. But again, God really does challenge the critics to look who's behind that open door, that the power that created the universe is behind it. And I mean, he just very forcefully says, no man can shut that door. That's quite an inspiring statement. If you look at Luke 1, verses 30 through 33, I'll not read it, but you can go and read it yourself, and I wish you would, because the heart of this key of David is the fact that Jesus Christ is going to return and sit on a throne that is already on this earth. It's already on this earth. He's going to sit on it and rule over the world forever. Now, that's what those verses say, and that's what you need to be concerned about, I believe, that because that's, as I said, getting right at the heart of the message. Notice verse 21 of Revelation 3. To him that overcomes will I grant to sit with me in my throne, even as I also overcame and am set down with my Father in his throne. So, what God says we have to do is overcome as Christ overcame. Now, if we do that, we get to sit on a throne with Christ right there in Jerusalem. We get to sit on that throne with him in the headquarters, and that for 1,000 years, and then I'm going to show you in a moment for a lot longer than that, like for eternity. But I think that's probably the greatest reward that God gives to any collective body of any era of his church. You can sit right there on that throne in Jerusalem forever with Christ, if you can fathom that. See, this last era has more of God's truth than any other, and it resides in a little flock or a little remnant. They have kept God's word, and they're going to be God's headquarters bride. But this key of David has to be revealed. All of God's truth is revealed. But who does God reveal it to? Well, it says in Matthew 11, verse 25, he reveals it unto babes. And then in Matthew 18, verses 1 through 3, it says, you have to become childlike or you won't have this revealed to you. God won't reveal it to anybody except a babe. You have to really be very humble, and then God will give you revelation and then more revelation. And you'll know that there's something really exciting going on through that door. That revelation from God is being delivered right through that door to all of humanity. And what a wonderful message it is. Now, you can prove that to yourself. And you can prove that God is still giving new revelation to his church. But let's go on in verse 8. Verse 8 of Revelation 3. I know your works. Behold, I have set before you an open door, and no man can shut it. For you have a little strength, and have kept my word, and have not denied my name. Christ says, I have set before you an open door. So Christ is the head of the church. He's set the open door there. And now he repeats this again, that I will open a door for you, and no man will shut it. No man. And I will shut some doors, he says, and no man will stop that either. God is fully in control here. Jesus Christ is fully in control, and he tells this little flock, look, I'll open the door for you if you do your part. And I'll galvanize this world somewhat with a message, though not as much today as he should, but it will begin to really ring true when people are going through some very difficult trials. But again, you see, he challenges the skeptics and says, look, if you have talking to his Philadelphians, if you have a childlike attitude, if you're like, have this babe attitude, I will empower you to deliver my message, my Key of David message, through that open door to this world. And you can absolutely be assured the message will be delivered, and I won't let anybody stop it.